No, I really, that's one thing I didn't plan to become as a contest organizer. And I still don't see us or myself or Christoph and I as a contest organizer. It was more like things luckily fell into place where our friend called us.
Olli called me up at the Neujahrsspringen, the ski jumping competition, and he was like, yeah, I have the possibility to use that stadium, let's do something.
He didn't really say what the something was or if he wanted to do an event. He kind of asked us because we've built something with him before.
The possibilities we had were pretty good, like it's a huge stadium and we could bring as much snow as we wanted to.
You know, it doesn't happen that often that you can create the jump of your dreams and have it stable at a certain location for an entire week. Christoph and I instantly had the idea that we could build the jump that we've worked on for a long time, but build it in a stadium and maybe even have an audience. Yeah, it was about 4 years ago when Christoph and I and Chris Engelsman, we were filming for a robot food film. We came upon this feature. I don't think I've ever seen anything like that.
This right there would be the in run. You take all the speed taken off in direction of Christoph with a mega, mega Wu-Tang super pop.
Jumping in!
Why, Lucy, your eyes are filled with tears.
My heart is filled with blood. Dance with me, George.
Did he land?
Woo-hoo!
Did he land?
Umkam, als ich Lander gesehen habe, war ich gerade so ungefähr in der Mitte vom Herzensprung. Und dann alles nur noch runtergeflogen.
Viel schneller! Ist das scary oder nicht? Holy moly, that's the craziest feeling in the world. Leck mich macht das Spaß. Das ist so unglaublich. Das ist so krass, wenn wir die Kuppel kommen. Looks like it's time for that certain holiday. This is way too good of a jump to do a backside 7.
Our longest airtime was over 3 seconds, which was amazing.
And I think, like, once we realized what kind of potential the jump had, we just kind of went nuts because we were all so excited.
We can hit this exact same jump again to the left tomorrow. Guys, ready? A little weak, a little pale today. Looks like it's time for that certain holiday.
Looks like it's time. We were used to jump the normal cheese wedge style backcountry kicker. And after that, standing there and thinking, what can we do? We can't really jump cheese wedges anymore.
Yeah.
That was the moment when I realized this jump has like twice the airtime that I've ever had on any other jump. All I have to do is just find a feature like that or even rebuild it, and we can try whatever we want without facing any consequences.
That one was rad. Flying, flying, flying.
So going from there, it was kind of our idea. You give people a setup that is so good and so safe that they could really progress.
So I started doing those animations and showed the people how it should look like.
What Christoph was looking at was basically a skyscraper of snow that would just like pack into the stadium and build a jump on top.
When we first checked the stadium, nobody could really imagine how a 20 meter high snow mountain would look at that place.
So this is the place where it's going to happen, the Olympic Stadium in Garmisch.
70 meters ungefähr.
And this is where there will be 50,000 cubic meters of snow.
25 meters left, 25 meters right, 25 meters high, 50,000 tons of snow. Pretty big, massive.
We sat down with the city of Garmisch, Red Bull and Nitro, and 1 week later we had the decision to do it. See a lot of machines working. What we basically do right now is getting all the snow together. We have 15 trucks that bring every 3 minutes a full truck load of snow. We see behind me is going to be the jump. Doesn't really look like it right now. That is the dirty snow, lying around on parking lots, on roofs, wherever it's in the way. Really friendly people helping us building that jump. Amazing how just a small idea started such a big progress now. For the first 2 weeks, we were just pushing snow and it was just like a huge pile of snow. And the hard part was to get the shape of the jump, because to shape out all the sides and make the landings and the jumps was quite a lot of work.
Build it again.
The thing is that we have to push this forward too, so like,
yeah,
there is...
But pushing is a different thing than...
So big.
It's so big.
Hard to jump.
Yeah. It's one of those things where you could
it's easy to make like a real big mistake.
Yeah.
It's doable, but it's kind of crazy too.
Yeah.
Went to the stadium and saw the like the half finished jump for the first time. I was definitely a little scared that like what happens if we invite 10 or 12 riders and everyone flies in and the jump doesn't work.
I heard about it, in January.
Christoph sent me an email with all the sketches, how it's supposed to look.
It was pretty hard to imagine how does it look at the end. At
first I thought I got some wrong sketches or somebody was really bad because everything looks so big.
David told me, he's like, Travis, you're going to come here and it's going to be like a vacation.
It's going to be sick, I can't wait.
The first thing we did was going to Zugspitze.
I like Zugspitze.
Today is all about trying to feel our boards. I'm gonna get to chase some other guy. Who am I flying? Let's go. And I cry for some time. You know how. No, you know how. I try to hold it again. But you don't know.
Come on, guys!
Da ist kein Gap, das ist eine optische Illusion!
Ja klar ist der Schnee!
Ask me if there's snow.
Alright, here we go, look at it.
I didn't see that, I promise!
I didn't see that! I promise, I didn't look so different!
Getting everyone together and just going riding and kind of releasing like everyone from that pressure. And then when we got back to the jump, we had a huge air pillow.
When I first saw the jump, I was really impressed actually. Like from the bottom, you see it's huge.
I don't know, it looks like a building just grew out of snow, like a big mountain. Your legs are wooden tied to
the city who has final say. I'm psyched. It's the first time I can land on my head in my life and nothing's gonna happen.
Jumping for the first time is something like you really hate and you just have to do it. It doesn't matter if I go come too short, I land on an air pillow. If I go a little further, I might make it.
Either way, if you go too short, you hit the bag.
Exactly. If you go too far, you go too far. Yeah.
I think you could air it. If you give yourself an ollie, I think you'll make it.
That's a better angle.
Get it, David. Go down it and air it.
Yeah, there is.
Check this thing out.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my God.
Hey, first day, the jump's up, and we cleared it.
That's awesome.
So that's all we need to do.
I thought I had the speed and I just didn't have it. I haven't cleared it yet, man. You guys are the only two who cleared it. Yeah. None of us cleared it.
It just feels like right now it's like shoot and then the lift just like...
Yeah.
I want it to be more progression friendly. What's not progression friendly right now?
It's scary how fast we go into
it's
it.
It's too scary.
Yeah, we can't do switch or regular tricks. Drifted right and then missed the airbag and hit the deck on the right.
Aber ich habe so richtig schon gesehen, so ich so in der Luft, ich so holy shit.
After I had that sketchy slam next to the air pillow, people kind of got scared too, and everyone realized like, if I really wanted to try tricks, we have to make this thing smaller just because of the speed.
If you make it lower, the only thing that we don't have to do is fill up that much on the landing. Hey, let's go back to the hotel and have a meeting about that stuff.
I don't know if we have to do both. If we have to cut it down and push the jump in and take the landing.
Ob du einfach weiter oben landen kannst und.
Can we define exactly what the problem is?
I think we should push the jump forward.
Yeah. Auf alle Fälle. Aber ich sag dir nur, also wir können das so lassen.
The problem is like to change a big jump like this or a big transition like this a tiny bit. It means pretty much the work starts again all over. It just felt like we destroy everything and we are not able to build it up again.
Luckily, I didn't even know about the snow issues they had.
We'd be shaping warm snow, and then it would get colder, so the snow would either get like really dry or really cold, and it wasn't packing together very well.
The dirty snow from the town, the artificial snow, then real snow. There was for sure some moments, like, you know, everybody's under pressure to get the jump finished in time, and the sun went down and it's dark, and mm-hmm. I'm still standing there.
Ich denke halt immer nur, wenn wir schon die unten skifahren, wie sollen wir da oben dann gerade ankommen?
Nein, das ist auch nicht. Ich mache jetzt auch nicht mehr lang. Ich habe noch nichts gegessen heute. Mir ist wirklich schlecht. Und du musst mich aufstehen. Ich schiebe den Schnee hin, dann zurück, dann sagst du, es ist super, dann weiß ich es genau wie davor.
So, I'm pissed. I go to bed. Good night.
Every single day was like everyone checking the forecast, like, all right, it's good in the morning, then snow, and then good again. And
we had every different kind of weather you could imagine, from cold to snow to rain to sun. I think it was really good to do it over a week. It was awesome because then the riders really got to feel comfortable with each other, with the setup, and having the hotel right next to the jump. I mean, you couldn't ask for that better. I mean, we can see the jump out our windows.
Die klackerieren, dann sich darauf konzentrieren, das eigene dann's feiern und das andere negieren. Diese ganzen Patrioten, nationale Idioten, bitte seid so gut und stellt euch in ein Schwimmbad auf den Boden und winkelt's bis zum Hals euch alle gegenseitig an und dann taucht's noch einmal runter und dann nehmt's einen Schluck davon und spuckt's euch an damit so lang, bis das euch schlecht ist von der Kacke und wählen sie die Nummer neben ihrer Landesflagge. Wenn's dann ein Problem haben und sie kommen durcheinander, dann kommen's mit dem und das ist der Hausverstand. Mit dem können sie da alles erklären in sämtliche Verzierungen, im Heisel drin, im Fernseher, Regierungen, am besten mit dem Hausverstand ist eine in a Haus.
First of all, kind of getting a little nervous about this jump, right? Whoa. Cause the jump is huge, you know? At the moment is number one, enjoy the moment. Number two, we're going to snowboard in powder. And I'm gonna show you guys my new direction, which is regular foot, because I have retired my goofy foot stance. Look at that fucking sweet rail right there. Yeah, dude, you just ollie on and then ride the rail.
Vollkommen unpopper ist und was er nur mehr wundert. Wir sind so deppert und wollen zurück ins vorige Jahrhundert. die wollen jetzt mit Gewalt da die Ordnung, diese Pfeffen. Die halten das nicht aus, wenn was passiert ist, nicht begreifen. Die wollen eine klar karierte Welt und das auf dem Planeten. Und so wie es ist, schaut nicht so aus, als wenn sie bald vorhätten. Das Ohren und sie endlich einmal schleichen mit der Kacke. Und wählen sie die Nummer bitte neben ihrer Landesflagge. Kaka-Karierda, wird mal irgendwas dazu überstehen. Kaka-Karierda, der die Hosen nicht gleich voll hat, wenn irgendwas passiert ist, was er selber nicht versteht.
How much work you been doing today?
Non-stop, dude.
Since we left, since we were doing powder
time? Yeah, last, you know, 3 days straight.
Despite the changing conditions, I think we actually got pretty lucky. Just over the week, we just got to change it. We just shortened it up a little bit, lowered it, and gave it a little bit more pop. There's some bumps, but I think overall it was also successful.
It's a big jump, so I was sure that we're gonna run into some sort of problem, like we're gonna have to adjust something. It's really surprised how good like the shapers and everybody, like how much energy they put in and making it perfect and really good for the riders.
First impression is it looks pretty good. Everything looks fun and easy and no consequence.
Hey, Nick, now we're talking. So fun.
Really?
So fun. Macht es Spaß!
The weather turned really good, surprisingly, and we were like, oh, let's do that really fast. And the session started.
Team Cat.
cats with a suicide pack. You don't want to rap, just want to stack. You step into the spot and you get pushed to the back. Getting Trump money, almost forgot he was black. Mr. Police, man, I don't remind him of that. 27 years old, ain't ready to go. Trouble man got him on his way to the stove. Now he's in front of the judge and he's facing the road. And a few life digits with no chance of parole. Cellmate screaming, what you in here for? Man, nothing, I'm innocent, you already know. It's the same old lame old side-ass show. He was stuck on the fame like Rick on Blow. And it killed him fast, putting faith in crooks. Got took like the coalition of the willing. Cash, people, power, foreign soil, royal family, AIDS, oil, black.
When you go up there, the speed is just all the landing of a ski jump. Like the shape and all the setup is really good. It's big, but it's like safe. You feel really safe. You feel like you can almost try everything.
The step up and over style, you know, where if you get a little bit more pop, then you can, you have the time to go all the way down.
It's such a good idea because you can go so big and have so much air time and at the same time be safe.
I tried the double cork. I know, like on a normal jump, I would maybe I've never tried. Here's like, okay, then I can do everything maybe.
I didn't even plan on like trying like the double backflip to fakie. I kind of did it almost on accident the first try and I was like, okay, this is the perfect jump to like just try it on.
Dude. Someone does something and people kind of see it and think like, whoa, he feels that comfortable, it can't be that scary. And then people try something and it kind of like pushes everyone.
Double back, lay back someone at you or?
Where's the team session, isn't it?
Yeah.
Rock on, brother.
Gotta find a way to reach it out. I'm wild, tighter than a margin's cord. The longer I try to keep my mouth shut, the sooner little brain is gonna boil.
He just tried it for the first time.
This is gonna be really cool. I think he has something 1260-ish in mind.
Oh, oh my god.
Oh! The fucking 12! Are you kidding me?
That was insane! Oh, David.
Ooh, crazy feeling.
What a maniac.
Tried the first one and came around. I was like, oh man, it's not that hard.
It looked so sick from here. I didn't see the landing. Like how
I landed on my board, but just a little, like too much on this leg and too far down. Gripped, but feels good. Don't want to make a mistake. You know?
That's for sure.
Yeah.
That's
the Durka.
Oh, you fucking kidding. No way.
Frontside double cork, 12.
I've got to find a way to reach it out. I'm wound tighter than you.
It's so good.
We have a new crew.
How can you do that?
Wow.
How can you do that?
You know, most jumps that you're always used to riding, you know, you have it, you know, mentally like timed out in your head, you know, it's like, you know, pop, trick, come around, land. But this thing, it kind of opens up a lot of doors as far as like what's possible, what you thought you could do before. Like, you know, you could probably triple flip on that jump if you wanted to. Like, you got a lot of time.
Yeah, I'm ready, but you can go. And I'm going.
Oh.
No, see.
End of the day, like watching Frankie, man, like off the hip, you know, going to the landing.
That guy scares me, man.
Look at this.
Dude, that must have been too far for two.
We didn't have the plans of having the Shaper ride with us, but the whole week ended up being such a group effort that it was just natural to have Nick in the contest in the end. It was perfect, you know.
I didn't know with the weather this morning what was gonna happen. So many people showed up and they were all up on the hills.
We already had a really good session on Thursday and no one really touched the hip at all. As soon as there was an audience and there was a contest, people were trying to like go for the airtime.
David told me, he's like, Travis, you're gonna come here and it's gonna be like a vacation. And it really has been like a vacation.
And that's what was really fresh about this whole situation. It was, you know, come, like ride for a week. It's casual, but at the same time, it's progressive. And, you know, in the end, it really worked out really well. Let's do it.
What I really kept in my mind the most about the whole week was not certain tricks or certain sessions or something, but just how everyone stuck together, and it was just the whole week was one session.
I promise, I did look so different.
Yeah, it was nice sitting in the same hotel, seeing everyone at the breakfast. I wasn't there for the surfing, I missed it. I was pissed, but all the rest, the sled and the Bavarian restaurants.
Like how it is with the gondola all the time, all the riders together going up, then everybody rides and can have a look at the other riders' runs.
But you know, I saw like, what, four different people like do double corks? Perfect! We both walked away this weekend like doing something we've never done before, and for me it's like I can walk away really happy and content.
I spend all my
So we expect to be double the size of the pole.
These are about 25 meters. That's what we are talking about right now. You need a big neck for watching it.
I don't know if in a normal contest, slopestyle or anything, you could build a jump like this. It's like, I don't know how much snow did you move and stuff. It's huge.
Is that really true? 3,000 truckloads of snow?
I'm out of here. Oh. Tan that ass.
Okay, me too.
Oh. So, I say we push the jump forward.
Oh, yeah.
Little guy, huh?
Dude.
Yes, dude.
It's a tricky check.
I think it's really cool that you get people here. Let me check this out. I think it's really cool that you got everybody here early. God, I got boogers, major boogers.
But Marco and me are gonna be mad competitors. It's never just gonna stop, ever.
No.
The rivalry is just too deep-rooted already.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you just built this thing just to show everyone up, right?
That's exactly. And I built it kind of like fucked up, so I could be the only one riding it.
1080 Parken-Gierheim.
Parken-Gierheim?
Parken-Gierheim from 1080. 1080 Parken-Gierheim. Together with Travis.
Take those marbles out of your mouth.
We're marbles. Good time. Look at the pros. And that's how David plans his tricks, you know? There's a whole crew. And now they're talking what trick he should do tomorrow.
Say that one more time.
That's how David plans his tricks. There's like a whole crew that analyzes what he did good today and what wrong. And now they're talking about his switch double cork for tomorrow. Really pro.
So can you go around and tell me his committee? Who are those people? And what do they do?
Yeah, there's one dude. So let's go from the left. There's a the technical dude.
you just focus on his edges, how they are on the kicker, how straight he goes out of the kicker, and if he's like at the right position. Then there's the air dude, he looks at the high point and measures his curve and everything. Then there's the style girl, she checks like if he poked or how long he hold the grab. Then there's the landing committee, they basically evaluate, like they take super slow-mo shots of the landings and basically let him know if it was good enough or not. They're all communicating within the trick, you know, like within his riding, they all communicate to each other. So, and there's like a few more assistants, like this, it's a hard job, so they need help.